Welcome to our Wales and Korea prayer event. We're so glad that you could join us today praying together across our nations. The prayer event is going to be in three parts. First of all, we'll pray for Wales and then Korea and then pray for the world. So let's come in full confidence as we pray together, as it's written in 1 John. This is the confidence we have in approaching God, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hears us. And if we know that he hears us, whatever we ask, we know that we have what we asked of him. So let's pray. Lord, we come together in unity today as brothers and sisters across the world to worship you and to pray for our nations and to pray for our world. Hear our prayers, Lord, as we come to you in full confidence, our Father and our Lord, in Jesus' name, Amen. Let's start our time together by worshiping him.
Thank you. and welcome to this Wales Career Prayer event. I'm Julian Richards, the leader of New Wine Cymru, and it's been our privilege to team up with Pastor Jacob Hahn and our Korean friends at the Seoul Full Gospel Church with a vision to pray for each other and the nations. Wales and Korea share a spiritual history together. It was the Welshman Robert Germain Thomas who first brought the gospel to Korea in the 1800s. We're grateful for our Korean church friends who have been faithfully praying for Wales over many, many years. We trust that as we join together in prayer, Wales will catch the fire of prayer from our Korean brothers and sisters, and they too will receive a blessing from God as we unite in prayer today. So as we come to prayer, let's remember the prayer of the 1904 revival. Come, Holy Spirit. Come, Holy Spirit, more powerfully. Come, Holy Spirit, more powerfully, for Jesus Christ's sake. Amen. God heard that simple prayer, sent the power of His Spirit, and thousands of people came to Christ, and a nation and nations were revived as a result. And God can do the same again. So I'd now like to welcome Pastor Jacob Hahn, who will lead us in prayer for Wales.
Thank you, Julian. 웨일즈 모든 그리스도인들에게 인사를 전합니다. 여기 한국에서 여러분하고 같이 기도할 수 있어서 우리에겐 너무 큰 축복을 받은 것 같아요. 2019년 폴과 줄리안이 이곳 한국에 왔습니다. 그때 저를 만나 같이 기도하며 예배하며 우리가 비전을 나눴는데 성령의 운행하심이 있었어요. 우리의 마음이 뜨거워지고 우리 교인들도 영국 웨일즈를 향한 마음이 더 한판 올라갔다고나 할까요? 그때 우리가 줄리안하고 폴 목사님하고 같이 기도했을 때 하나님이 이런 성회로 계속 연결해 주실 것을 우리가 기대했는데 오늘 드디어 이런 순간을 맞이하게 되었습니다. 우리 한국은 웨일즈와 깊은 연관이 있습니다. 우리의 복음의 시작은 웨일즈로부터입니다. 여러분의 나라 웨일즈, 거기에 한 젊은이 로버트 저메인 토마스 선교사가 우리나라에 와 한 권의 성경을 전해준 결과 우리가 복음을 알기 시작한 것이에요. 그래서 우리는 웨일즈에게 감사를 전하고 있습니다. 그것을 계기로 2016년 저와 저의 교인들 98명이 영국 웨일즈로 넘어갔던 일을 여러분 기억하시나요? 웨일즈의 많은 목사님 부부를 초청했습니다. 시청에서 만찬을 했었습니다. 그때 여러분하고 같이 기도하며 찬양하며 우리가 비전을 나눴고 그 다음날 웨일즈의 세인트 데이비드 홀을 빌려서 우리가 예배했습니다. 과연 사람들이 올까 생각했는데 그렇게 많은 웨일즈 사람들이 1층부터 3층까지 꽉 차고 한국과 영국, 영국과 한국이 하나 되어 하나님께 예배할 때 하나님의 영광이 그 홀에 가득했던 것을 알 수 있습니다. 그때 우리가 20만 명의 웨일즈 사람들이 복음을 듣게 해달라고, 20만 명의 웨일즈 사람들이 주께 돌아오게 해달라고 함께 하나님께 소리질러 부르짖어 기도했던 걸 기억하시죠? 이제 그것에 연속된 사역이, 기도 사역이 이루어진 것을 너무너무 감사합니다. 저는 이 기도회에 큰 꿈을 갖고 있습니다. 이 기도회에 큰 기대가 있습니다. 왜냐하면 기도는 만사를 변화시킨다. 기도는 모든 것을 변화시키기 때문입니다. 우리가 물리적으로는 떨어져 있으나 영국과 한국, 웨일즈와 한국이 같이 기도하게 될 때 하나님은 성령의 운행하심으로 기적과 이적을 나타내실 줄 믿습니다. 저는 웨일즈에게 세 개의 기도 제목을 전합니다. 첫째, 웨일즈의 모든 처치 리더, 모든 지도자들, 리더십들이 love and unity, 사랑과 단합, 하나 될 수 있도록 기도해 주십시오. 두 번째, 웨일즈 사람들이 마음 문을 열고 활짝 열려서 웨일즈 교회로 들어오는 꿈을 꿉니다. 이 복음을 받아들일 수 있도록 마음 문이 열 수 있도록 여러분 기도해 주십시오. 마지막 세 번째입니다. 웨일즈 각 교회마다 하나님의 성령의 기적이 일어나기를 원합니다. 말씀이 떨어질 때 기적이 일어날 줄 믿습니다. 이 세 가지를 위하여 여러분 기도할 때 하나님은 웨일즈를 축복하시고 기적과 이적으로 역사하셔서 웨일즈 대부흥처럼 다시 한번 부흥의 불길을 일으켜 주실 줄 믿습니다. 할렐루야!
بخودی اگر هر دو اینو گلن من زندی فرس پیدی داد کوویا گمری تیر دیانا این گلن داد کوویا گمری کفوردی افلا
تریگارد گیش نی دنر این سیفلها میلیون دایر اثرت راس او دیو ایل
Gamri tir diacha in gulad
dad kavya gamri kavorthi athla
Yes, Lord, we come in persistent prayer that you will remember Wales. Hear our cry, heal our land, and touch Wales with your fire. Now that brings us to the end of part one, and we're going to move to part two now, prayer for Korea. And so we hand over to Paul, who's already on Korean time.
Good evening, Pastor Jacob, in the Seoul Full Gospel Church. Great to be with you. It was only a year ago that Julian and I traveled across to South Korea, to your beautiful country and your wonderful people. And we had such a great time there. We were touched by your hospitality, your generous hospitality. And I loved being there. I loved the prayer meetings. I loved the church services. I loved going out for the meals. I loved the press conference. And when we returned to Wales, I was so blessed and so refreshed. So thank you, Pastor Jacob, and for the church. One of the things that I really enjoyed was being taken out for meals. I love food. And another thing I enjoyed was one of your elders kindly hired the South Korean national costume, and June and I put it on and wore it all day as we walked around. And when I came home, I showed a photograph of me in one of them, and Jane said, oh, Paul, you look good in that. So that was okay, wasn't it? And when we were there, we visited a number of places, and one of them was the border, South Korea, North Korea, and I found that incredibly moving, particularly the story about the musician who's written a piece called Reconciliation. And he took a grand piano and he took out the strings, the metal strings, and he replaced them with barbed wire from the fence on the border. And they transported this grand piano and put it in front of the fence on the border. And he played his reconciliation music. I thought that was very moving. And I know that one of your deep prayers is for there to be reconciliation between South Korea and North Korea. And we will pray for that and continue to pray for that. And one of the verses I go to in scripture quite often is in Corinthians, where Paul is talking about all that Christ Jesus has done for us. And it says this: all this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and gave us the ministry of reconciliation. And gave us the ministry of reconciliation. We will continue to pray for reconciliation between South Korea and North Korea. I loved going to the prayer meeting and seeing the prayer rooms where you had to bend down to get into them. But there were two significant moments for me in South Korea. The first was when we were taken to the martyr cemetery, and these are people who've been killed and died for following Jesus, and they're buried there. And some of these are Koreans, and some of these are from other parts of the world, from the United Kingdom, from Germany, from America. And these were people who came and shared the love of Jesus and died for doing that. I found it an incredibly moving and humbling place to be, and I asked to go back the following day, and I sat in the cemetery and I read some of the stories of these remarkable people, and it so touched me and inspired me. The other place was when we gathered for the Wednesday night prayer meeting. We literally arrived that day, and we'd been to a number of events already, and we walked into your lovely building and that lovely warm welcome, and the choir was singing and the worship leaders were up there. And after the introductions, we began to worship together. And you very kindly put the Korean words up with the English words underneath. So Julie and I joined in the worship. And as we worship, I sensed a touch of the Holy Spirit. And I sensed God asked me something that he wanted me to do. It was an incredibly humbling moment for me. And so we came. We made some good friends. We love your people. We love the nation of South Korea. And we will continue to pray for you. And now I invite you again to come, let's worship together, South Korea and Wales. Let's join together worshiping the living Jesus Christ.
people of Wales, how's going? I think the situation in Wales is getting better. But Korea is undergoing a big COVID pandemic. Still, we are tough circumstances. My congregation and I, Jacob Hahn, are very happy to gather together in prayer. God is going to answer our prayer tonight. I hope to see you soon. Take care.거룩하신 하나님, 대한민국을 하나님께 올려드립니다. 코로나 속에서 신음하고 있는 대한민국을 불쌍히 여겨주시옵소서. 우리 믿는 자들이 먼저 하나님 앞에 무릎 꿇고 회개하며 나아갑니다. 우리를 용서하시고 이 저주받은 코로나 뿌리가 뽑혀 밖으로 쏟아져 버리게 도와주시옵소서. 우리가 일상으로 돌아갈 수 있도록 하나님 길을 열어주시옵소서. 각 교회들이 다시 성전문이 그랜드 오프닝 될 수 있도록 축복을 나리워 주시옵소서. 코로나로부터 어려움을 당하고 자가격리를 당하며 확진되었던 모든 한 사람 한 사람을 위로하여 주시고 주의 신유, 주의 보혈의 능력이 그들에게 임하여서 완치되게 역사하여 주시옵소서. 하나님, 이 코로나로부터 자유하기를 원합니다. 아버지, 예수 믿는 사람이 마지막 때 복음으로 우뚝 쓰고 믿음으로 우뚝 쓴다고 하셨사오니 아버지, 우리가 하나님께 예배하고 찬양할 때 이 코로나가 우리에게서 끊어져 버릴 줄 믿습니다. 거룩하신 아버지, 대한민국의 모든 정치적인 상황, 경제적인 상황, 문화적인, 사회적인, 가정, 하나님 잡아주시옵소서. 좌로나 우로나 치우치지 않게 도와주시옵시고 부부가 하나 되게 하시고 부모 세대와 자녀 세대가 하나 되게 도와주시옵시고 아버지, 사람들이 서로 하나 될 수 있는 역사가 있게 도와주시옵소서. 이 대한민국을 높이 들어 사용하심을 감사합니다. 마지막 때 정말 땅끝까지 이르러 복음이 전달하는 대한민국 되게 도와주시옵시고 성령의 역사를 나타내는 대한민국 교회 되게 도와주시옵소서. 하나님, 선교가 끊어지지 않게 하시옵소서. 전도가 끊어지지 않게 하시옵소서. 우리의 모든 선교사역에 하나님 힘을 더하여 주시옵시고 눈물로써 선교사역을 감당하는 자들을 축복 내려 주시옵소서. 각 교회의 성전문이 열리기를 원합니다. 아버지, 각 성도들의 어려움을 하나님 보아주시옵소서. 각 가정마다, 각 회사마다, 직장마다, 인생마다 하나님, 경제적인 코로나로 어려움을 당하고 있습니다. 이들의 재정 문제를 하나님 아시오니 물질의 물꼬가 열리게 도와주시옵시고 매매와 거래와 계약이 이루어지게 하여 주시옵소서. 저들이 갖고 있는 아버지 라이센스에 축복하시고 저들의 주민등록번호와 사업자 등록증을 축복하시고 저들의 직장을 축복하여 주셔서 하나님, 저의 이름을 창대케 하여 주시옵소서. 시작은 미약하였으나 나중에 창대케 하신다는 하나님의 말씀을 믿습니다. 그 약속의 말씀이 우리 인생 가운데 드러나는 대한민국 되게 도와주시옵소서. 모든 물질의 어려움에서 풀림이 있게 하여 주시옵소서. 하나님, 이 기간 동안에 가정이 끊어지지 않도록, 가정이 해체되지 않도록 가정을 하나님께 부탁드립니다. 부부가 하나 되게 도와주시고 자녀와 부모 세대가 하나 되게 도와주시고 아버지, 마지막 때 싱글 라이프 또한 하나님께서 기회를 허락하여 주시옵소서. 이 모든 말씀을 살아계신 예수님 이름으로 축복하며 기도드렸습니다. 아멘.
Thank you, Lord. We worship your holy name. Thank you for your great love for us and your grace and mercy towards us. Amen. Well, thank you to the worship band and our friends there in Korea and to Pastor Jacob. Thank you for all your contribution. It's fantastic to worship and pray together. And now we move on to part three. So I'll hand over to Rachel Radborn in North Wales, who's going to take us through part three, Prayer for the World.
Hi, and welcome to our final section, Praying for the World. I'm Rachel Radborn, speaking from the beautiful village of Paradwys in northwest Wales. We're so grateful to God for this beautiful world that He's given us, every part of the reflecting His care and love of the Creator. Even the stones would cry out in praise, and the trees clap their hands. So, let's come together to pray. To pray for our beautiful world and for every people, tribe and nation, in gratitude and for the needs of our world right now, for unity and for peace, for mutual respect and value for every person, for health and protection, and that hearts would turn to Him. Arglwydd molwn dy enw di am y byd rhyfeddol rwyt wedi chreu I ni fwynhau. Am phob pobl, llwyth a chanedl. Codwm fawl o'n chalon am prydferthwch ac amrywiaeth y cenhedloedd. Rydym yn galw arna ti, Arglwydd, a'n colonnau'n codi I godi anghenion ein byd. Amen. I'm now going to pass over to Kath, who's going to lead us into the next section with worship. So thank you, the lovely Kath Woolridge.
Thank you so much, Rachel. Well, let's worship together now as we come and pray for our world. You know, I'm out here in my garden and I can hear the birds tweeting away in their song of worship. And I love that verse in Isaiah 55, where it says, you will go out with joy and be led forth in peace, and the mountains and the hills will burst into song before you, and all of the trees will clap their hands. Doesn't that paint an amazing picture of the amazing world that God has created, and the fact that nature joins in our praise? So let's worship Him together now.
Thank you. everybody has a future because of what was won for us on the cross and because of what was won for us because of the empty tomb. We thank you, Lord, in your holy name. Amen. Well, thank you so much for worshipping with us. I'm now going to hand back over to Julian.
Thanks, Cass. Such a beautiful song there. Thank you. We're going to spend some time now praying together for our world. Let's pray for unity and peace, that as communities, divisions of injustice and prejudice will be broken down, where the value of every individual is respected and honoured. Let's pray for this worldwide pandemic that we find ourselves in, for the hurting and the grieving, for those providing healthcare around the clock, and for all those in leadership, science, education, key workers, and everyone affected. We pray for all those caught up in poverty across our world. Let's pray about climate change, that we learn urgently once again how to care for our world and be responsible in our actions. And Lord, we pray that many will turn to you and come to know you. Strengthen every church in reaching out at this time. Let's pray now. Ephesians 6:18 says, "And pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. And with this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the Lord's people." Lord, we come to you. We celebrate this amazing world that you've given us. Help us to care for it wisely as the gift that it is. And for us to come with humble hearts in the way that we treat one another, fearfully and wonderfully made in your image. We ask you to renew our love for our neighbour. We call on you to rescue in the midst of this worldwide pandemic. We pray that many will turn to you across our world. In Jesus' name, amen. Prayer points will appear on your screen. Please do pray for any other pressing needs in your part of the world.
Thank you.
Our time together to a close. It's been a real privilege to worship and pray together across the nations. And let's close our time together with these words from Zephaniah 3:17. The Lord your God is with you. He is mighty to save. He will take great delight in you. He will quiet you with his love. He will rejoice over you with singing. So as we close, let's go in full confidence and faith, knowing that God hears our prayer, but knowing too that he delights in you, that he loves you, and that he goes with you. Thanks for being together with us. God bless you and goodbye.
Thank you for joining us in prayer today. God bless you and goodbye.